Hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to start part 4 of conditional and looping constructs chapter. The first topic is converting while loop into for loop. A question comes in the exam, a while loop is given to you and you have to convert that into a for loop. Let us see the example. The program says x equals to 5, while x less than 10, print x plus 10. And x plus equals to 2. Here we have taken a variable x whose value is 5. The condition is till the time the value of x is less than 10, it should print the statement x plus 10, that is the value. And after printing each statement, it should increment the value of x by 2. So the initial value is known as the start value. The condition is the stop, and the increment or decrement is the step. As we have seen while working in the for loop in the last class, that for control variable in range, the range function consists of the parameters, that is start, stop and step. So we have to identify here ki which are the values that are start, stop and step. So this is the starting value 5. It has to go till less than 10, that is it will go till 9. And it says print x plus 10 and x plus is equal to 2. This is the shorthand notation of writing any variable with increment or decrement. The statement means that x equals to x plus 2. If we want to convert this while loop into for loop, we have to write like this. For, take the variable which has been used here. Here the name of variable is x. So write here x. In is a keyword. Range is the name of the function. Start the parameters. What is the value of start here? 5. What is the value of stop? 10. It takes one value less till 9. That is why we have taken here 10. Then take the step. That is a gap is of 2. Close the parenthesis and put a colon sign. Whatever is there in the body part of while loop, the same thing we have to write as print statement in the for loop. It says print x plus 10. So here we have to write print x plus 10. By mistake it has been written here 2. It will come here x plus 10. And this increment statement is not to be written since we have given this step in the parameters only. Let us understand how its output will come. X equals to 5. 5 is less than 10. Condition is true. Print x plus 10. So value of x is 5. 5 plus 10 becomes 15. So first it will print 15. Then x plus is equal to 2. Value of x is currently 5. 5 plus 2 becomes 7. Again it will go to the test expression. 7 is less than 10. Condition is true. So it will print x plus 10. That is 7 plus 10. So the answer will be 17. And then we have is x plus equals to 2. So the value of x is now 7. 7 plus 2 equals to 9. It again goes to the test expression. 9 less than 10, condition is true. So print 9 plus 10, 19. The answer is 19. Next time the value of x becomes 9 plus 2, that is 11. Again, it will check the test expression 11 less than 10. Now the condition has become false, so it will not go inside the body of the while loop. The loop will be terminated here only and it will give the output as 15, 17, 19. The 17 will be printed in the next line and 19 below 17, since print statement always gives the output in a new line. So this is the way of converting the while loop into a for loop. Similarly, if you have been given a for loop, the same way you have to convert it into a while loop. The main thing which you have to remember is this is the start value which you have to initialize in the starting. Then the stop value has to be given with the while keyword as a condition. And the step has to be given separately after the body, after in the body of the while, after giving any print statement. So I hope conversion is clear to you. This is our while loop and this is our. Next we have is nested loops. A loop may contain another loop as a part of its body. So this loop inside a loop is known as nested loop. Ek program mein ek loop ke andar dusra loop ho sakta hai. So this way when there is a loop inside a loop, this is known as the nested loop. Now the syntax of a nested while loop is while test expression. Then in the body of this while loop, we have another while loop, while test expression, statement, statement, statement. Now you have to understand that the first statement which is written here, it is the body of the inner while loop. The second statement which is being written here, this is the body of the outer while loop. And the last statement which has been written here, it is out of both the loops. Let us see an example. I equals to 0 while I less than equal to 2. J equals to 0 while J less than equal to 2. Print 2 comma and equals to space. J equals to J plus 1. Print I plus I equals to I plus 1. The initial value of I is 0. This while loop is outside, so this is the outer loop, and this J is equal to 0 till this J equals to J plus 1. Till here it is the outer loop, and this while loop is the inner loop from here till J equals to J plus 1. Let us start its execution. I equals to 0. 0 less than equal to 2. Condition is true. So we have taken another variable, J equals to 0. Currently the value of I is 0 and J is also 0. Now the inner while loop will work with the value of J. 0 less than equal to 2. Is 0 less than equal to 2? Yes. Condition is true. So what it has to print? It has to print 2 and give a space. So first it will print this 2 and give a space. Cursor will come here. Then it says J equals to J plus 1. Initially the value of J was 0. 0 plus 1 becomes 1. So now when the value of J becomes 1, it will not go to the outer loop. First it will complete the inner loop till the condition evaluates to false. Here it will check 1 less than equal to 2. Is 1 less than equal to 2? Yes, the condition is again true. So it will print 2 and give a space. Now J becomes J plus 1. The value of J is 1. So 1 plus 1 becomes 2. Again it will go to the test expression. That is the condition. It will check 2 less than equal to 2. Yes, the condition is again true. So it will print 2 and here and equals to space. So it will print 2 and give a space, and the cursor will come a little this side. Now value of J becomes 2 plus 1, that is 3. 3 less than equal to 2. Now here the condition becomes false. So it will not go inside this body of the loop and it will come to the outer part of the while loop. After this completion of the inner loop, we have this print statement, and it says print. There is nothing inside the parameters. There is no parameter inside the parentheses. So when only print statement is written with parentheses, it brings the cursor to the new line. Our cursor was here, so it will go to the new line. And I equals to I plus 1. I, the value of I was 0. 0 plus 1 becomes 1. Now it will go to the test expression. 1 less than equal to 2. Condition is again true. J equals to 0. Now here the value of I has incremented to 1. And J will again start from 0. 0 less than equal to 2. Condition is true. So it will print 2 in the second line. Then J plus 1 becomes 1. 1 less than equal to 2, again it will print 2. This 2 will be printed, then space. Then J is incremented by 1. 2 less than equal to 2, condition is true. Print 2 here. Now again J becomes J plus 1, that is 3. 3 less than equal to 2, condition is false. It will come out of the loop and it will go to the print statement, which will shift the cursor to the next line. Now the value of I becomes I plus 1. Earlier it was 1, so 1 plus 1 becomes 2. 2 less than equal to 2, condition is true. So again the whole process will be repeated. So we will understand this again. Initially the value of I was 0 and the value of J was also 0. So J continued till 0, 1, 2. Then the value of I became 1 and J started from the starting point, that is 0, then 1, then 2. Then the value of I again became incremented by 1 and it became 2. And again the value of J started and it started from 0 and went till 2, 0, 1, 2. So that is why our output has come. So you can say here I is for printing the columns and J is for printing the value in the rows. I is taking care of the number of columns and J variable is taking care of the number of rows. I hope this is clear to you. This is a little complex program. It may take some time to you, but you need to practice this practically. 2-3 times when you will practice, you will easily understand these types of programs. Only the thing which you have to take care is about the outer loop and the inner loop. Next is nested for loop. We have learnt about the two looping constructs, that is for loop and while loop. So for loop can also be nested. How? The syntax is for control variable in range parameters, that is the syntax to write the for loop. Inside this we are writing a for loop again and then giving the statement. One is the statement for the inner for loop, this one, and other statement is for the outer for loop, that is this one. Now let us take an example. For I in range 0, 3, 0 is the starting value, 3 is the ending value. Then again one for loop is there, so this is the nested for loop. For j in range 0, 3, print 2 and equals to space, then print. So what is the meaning of this one? This is the same question which we have done with the help of while loop. We have seen that in that the value started from 0 and went till 2. We also want here the value to go till 2. That is why we have to take one value extra, that is 3. First of all, the loop will start with I value 0 and J value 0. So 0 will be printed, 2 will be printed 3 times. That is first 0th time, then first time, then second time. Then as soon as it becomes 3, it will come out of this loop because 3 value cannot be taken. Then it will go to this print statement and go to the next line, that is this line, and then it will go to the outer for loop and change the value of I to 1. So I becomes 1 and J will again start from 0, that is 0, 1, 2. Second line will be printed. Next time I becomes 2 and J again starts from 0, that is 0, 1, 2. So this line will be printed. So here also you can say the I variable is for the columns and the J variable is for the rows. Try this program in Python and you will understand its output. So here one question, another is also there, that is finding the error in the given program. Now the program is x equals to int enter value for x. For in range 0, 11, if x equals to y, print x plus y, else print x minus y. Whenever such type of question comes for finding the error, you have to start from the first statement and check whether all the syntax is correct or not. Now what is syntax? Syntax is the general rule of writing any program. Like when you write a paragraph or an essay in English, you take care of the tenses part. If the tenses are wrong, the meaning of sentence gets the different. Similarly, when you are working in any program in any language, there are certain rules for that language, and if there is any discrepancy in following those rules, then there will be an error. So the first statement says x equals to int enter value for x. You know that this statement is taking the value of x from the user, and we also know the thing that whenever we have to take the value from the user, we have to use which function? Input function, which is not used here, and that is the first error. So this is with the green color I have highlighted the errors. When you will do this type of question in the exam, you have to underline the errors and the correction part you have to write down. Whatever you have corrected, that you have to underline. So here input function will come and a parenthesis will be added after the int function. And here after that it says for in range 0, 11. Now we have learnt the syntax of the for loop, that after the for keyword a control variable has to come, but in this line there is no control variable, so we have to check what control variable will come here. We know from the first statement that we have taken the value of x from the user, and in the next line we are comparing the value of x with y. So here the control variable will be y, for y in range 0, 11. Now there is one more error here, that the range function takes the value in parenthesis, not in the square brackets. So instead of the square brackets, we have to use the parentheses. And you have to take care of the colon sign also. If the colon sign is not there, though it is there in this program, but if it is not there, that will also be considered an error. Next statement says, if x equals to y, whenever we are comparing the values of the two variables, always use equal to operator. This is equal to equal to. This is assignment operator. This will assign the value of y to x. इस ऑपरेटर से आप राइट हैंड साइड की वैल्यू को लेफ्ट साइड के वेरिएबल में असाइन करते हैं. बट इफ़ यू वांट टू चेक वेदर दे आर इक्वल और नॉट, यू नीड टू गिव इक्वल इक्वल टू साइन. देन इट सेज प्रिंट एक्स प्लस वाई एल्स प्रिंट एक्स माइनस वाई. नाउ दीज टू स्टेटमेंट्स आर हेयर एंड वी हैव टू यूज देम एज अ प्रिंट फंक्शंस. सो वी नो दैट व्हाइल राइटिंग द फंक्शन वी हैव टू गिव द पैरेंथेसिस व्हिच वी हैव नॉट गिवन. सो दैट इज अगेन एन एरर. So this is the way you have to find the error in the program. In the first statement, you should check whether the type conversions, that is in float, values are given or not, input function is written or not. Then when you are working with any loop or any of the conditional statements, you have to check the operators and the colon sign, that is the general rules of the program. Now let's come to the assignment part. The first question says, convert the following while loop to for loop and for loop to while loop. First part is of converting the while loop to for loop, and second part is of converting the for loop to while loop. Third part is not a conversion question, it is to find the errors. So in this case, you have to check what are the errors. And in question number 2, you need to write a program to perform addition and subtraction of the two numbers depending upon the input provided by the user. यूजर से आपको एक इनपुट लेना है और वो इनपुट आपका किस फॉर्म में होगा, ऑपरेटर की फॉर्म में. या तो आप यूजर से प्लस लेंगे या माइनस लेंगे. तो उन दोनों वैल्यूज में से या उन दोनों ऑपरेटर्स में से वट एवर ऑपरेटर द यूजर विल गिव, अगर यूजर ने प्लस साइन दिया तो उस टाइम पे द आउटपुट शुड बी ए प्लस बी. यानी कि जो वैल्यू आप यूजर से ले रहे हैं और जो आप ऑपरेटर ले रहे हैं उसके अकॉर्डिंग दोनों वैल्यूज को आपको ऐड कराना है. एंड इफ़ दैट पर्सन गिव्स माइनस एज द इनपुट, देन आपको दोनों वैल्यू को सब्ट्रैक्ट करवाना है. एंड दिस प्रोग्राम यू हैव टू डू विद द हेल्प ऑफ इफ एल्स स्टेटमेंट. आप एक फर्स्ट कंडीशन में आप सबसे पहले तो आप क्या करोगे, व्हेन यू विल राइट अ प्रोग्राम, देन यू कैन टेक एनी टू वेरिएबल्स और इनपुट फंक्शन की हेल्प से आप यूजर से दो वैल्यूज इनपुट कराओगे, इंटीजर वैल्यूज और फ्लोट वैल्यूज. देन आप क्या करेंगे, आप यूजर से नेक्स्ट स्टेटमेंट में एक ऑपरेटर भी इनपुट कराएंगे. देन यू विल टेक द हेल्प ऑफ इफ स्टेटमेंट और उसमें आप कंडीशन लगाएंगे कि अगर यूजर ने ऑपरेटर दिया है प्लस तो आपको क्या प्रिंट कराना है, ए प्लस बी. एंड नेक्स्ट टाइम पे अगर यूजर ने ऑपरेटर दिया है माइनस तो आप क्या प्रिंट कराएंगे, ए माइनस बी. ए माइनस बी मीन्स जो भी आपने दो नंबर्स लिए उनको सब्ट्रैक्ट करके जो वैल्यू आएगी, दैट यू हैव टू गेट इट प्रिंटेड. तो जब हमें वैल्यू प्रिंट करानी होती है, वी डोंट राइट द वेरिएबल्स इन द सिंगल कोट्स और द डबल कोट्स. ट्राई दीज प्रोग्राम्स एंड डू ऑल द असाइनमेंट्स इन योर नोटबुक.